A video about the AC properties of capacitors, and then especially say the AC resistance. The term AC resistance is a very obsolete and perhaps in modern electronics books you don't find it any longer. But it is a very important, say, old school way to approach this problem. Not a problem, of course, but an issue. So here the AC resistance of a capacitor. The frequency is, say, in hertz. The capacitor is in farad. That's a very, very big value regarding the capacitance. And for instance, a capacitor of 0.47 microfarad at a frequency of 50 hertz, that's the mains frequency in the Netherlands, is 6775 ohms. And you can immediately see by all these zeros that we have to do with a kind of problematic calculation, but anyway, the calculation is right, and the most important thing to tell is that the frequency, that the resistance, the AC resistance of a capacitor depends on the frequency. That's, say, the most important thing to tell. That means that, say, a capacitor of 100 nanofarad, so 0.5 microfarad, has, say, a high, in certain terms, resistance on 100 hertz, but it has almost no resistance on, say, 20 kilohertz or 1 megahertz. Anyway, that's an important, say, conclusion of this formula. And furthermore, there's more to tell when we are talking about all these capacitors here. Related to the value to which we calculate, that is the farad in the earlier formula, we see, for instance, that the capacitor of 1 picofarad is 10 to the 12 minus compared to the to a capacitor of 1 farad. So the 1 farad is an enormous high value. And in calculations, perhaps not very good usable. Anyway, nowadays there are, say, 10 farad capacitors, 100 farad capacitors used, super caps used in electric motors, etc. The only aim of this video is to, say, give some practical ideas. Here, at first, a warning. Don't connect electrolytics to AC, whatever, say 50 hertz, 60 hertz, etc., etc. Electrolytics have a polarity, and that polarity must always be taken into account. So, don't connect electrolytics to AC. They can explode, they can burn out, they can get very hot. When you reverse them, say, it also is a problem, but anyway. So, the first interesting thing about such a capacitor circuit is the so-called capacitive voltage divider. Say we have here 50 volts. And say this capacitor is, you can try it out, by the way, 450 nanofarad or 1 microfarad, bipolar, of course. Bipolar. This is the typical example of such a capacitor. 1 microfarad, bipolar, they are big. They can handle, say, 300 volts or so, or whatever. And of course, this could also be a 470, but anyway, say it's 470 nanofarad, and here also 470 nanofarad, or 1 microfarad, bipole, you have here the AC voltage divided. You can use the formula that I showed earlier in that book. But say we have here 50 volts, then we have here 25 volts. AC, of course. And, well, could be useful. And even in the 1950s, I want to give this demo, but it's a bad example. It's not safe. There was a circuit where we had 230 volts AC and a capacitor, and then we had a tube, and the filament of the tube was connected via a capacitor and then back to the AC. And that capacitor was, say, searched out so that there was the right value on the filament in terms of currents and voltage. Well, there are, say, good things. And the good thing of such a solution is that there is no heat developed in that capacitor. When you say want to drop 230 volts to say 6 volts and you use a resistor, well, you can do the calculations, use Ohm's law, etc., etc., watch and study and calculate, but such a resistor has such an enormous, has to say, work over such an enormous voltage drop compared to the current here that has to flow here, that it gets extremely hot. But such a capacitor does not get extremely hot. And that's, say, a good thing. I don't advise to do these experiments, but I'm absolutely sure that, say, in direct voltage supplies of whatever kind of the past 10 years, this solution is used. Anyway, I don't advise it because, for instance, when such a capacitor say gets hot due to the internal resistance that could be generated by all kinds of ways, by the dielectricum, by the dielectric material inside, it can get hot and it can explode. So, kind of bomb here. Not advised, but I want to tell it because, say, it is one of the ways that in the very past, say the 1950s, 1940s, a tube was, say, supplied at its filament with via a capacitor on 230 volts AC without generating heat. Anyway, back to this circuit, AC 50 volts, 450 nanofarad or 1 microfarad, bipolar, and say in this case when we have here 50 volts, say 100 volt capacitor will do the job. Also here 100 volt, don't take a too low voltage capacitor because we have the same problems that I've explained here. So we have here an AC voltage of 25 volts. For instance, it could be a good idea, say, when you want to supply a light emitting diode. Such a light emitting diode, normal LED, you can also try, for instance, a white LED. I did not test it, but anyway, here's a positive and here the negative, but because we connect it to AC, it doesn't matter. You can reverse the wires. But this, say, resistor is important. It limits the current. A normal LED hates AC, and the reason is that, say, on 50 hertz, 50 times a second, the voltage changes on the barrier layer of that LED. Here's the inside, there is a barrier layer, where the positive and the negative charges change, in this case with 50 hertz, constantly. So there could be heat. Much heat can be, say, developed. Heat that in a certain way is difficult to measure, because you have to insert here an AC voltmeter, an AC current meter, and of course it's possible, but anyway, normal LEDs don't like. So it works absolutely sure, and I've used this circuit in the past, and it worked. So take the value of such a resistor very conservative, say higher compared to the situation where we have to do with a DC source. So are there other possibilities? Yes, there are surely possibilities, and say it's important to tell, this is the, say, capacitive voltage divider, and it's important to tell that when the frequency where that capacitive voltage divider works is higher, say it is 20 kilohertz, what will be the effect? In fact, the whole, say, setup stays the same, but you can use smaller capacitors. For instance, say, 100 nanofarad capacitor here, and 100 nanofarad capacitor here. Say, it's 1000 volts, could be. And then we have here, for instance, 500 volts AC on 20 kilohertz. So that gives, again, possibilities, say, to get to certain working voltages when you have an oscillator here, for instance, that generate 20 kilocycles, and you can do the same calculations on the basis of the formula of my book. And for other frequencies that will also differ anyway, when these values are the same, you get a, say, equal voltage divide, equal voltage division. And when you change the value of these capacitors, say this is 10 nanofarad and this is 500 nanofarad, also the voltage will change, and the output voltage will also is related to the frequency. So no equal voltage any longer, but a different voltage. You can do the calculations on the basis of the formula, and it's much more interesting and better to do the calculations in practice. So make such a circuit, make a circuit that works on 20 kilocycles, gives out 1000 volts, do these experiments. Of course, these capacitors have to handle that super high voltage. Say, they must handle 3000 volts. Must be able to handle 3000 volts. And do these calculations and measure. And of course, you can do, say, a simple rectifier here. For instance, here is a high typical high voltage diode. Must be a typical high voltage diode. Other diodes don't work. They say can damp the oscillation circuit anyway. And then measure here the voltage. So again, do the calculation in practice, do some experiments, etc., etc. Thanks for watching. I hope it was a little bit clear. I hope I didn't shift the camera too much. So, again, thanks for watching.